Welcome back to another behind the sound video on the Lamborghini Aventador. My name is Ardil and welcome to our YouTube channel. Today's video and what these videos are all about is showcasing a little bit more about what goes on actually behind the scenes, showing you kind of the progress updates on each install that we're doing. So the Aventador, obviously an absolutely amazing car, and we've actually got another Aventador right next to me as well in front of me. In terms of the system that we're doing, we're going to be starting off the front end here and working our way back to going through exactly what we're adding in. The front end is basically in this tub area. This is where the roof actually sits in when the roof is off. What we've done is fabricated a panel. So this is the raw finish and then this is the finished product. Kind of, so this is basically an Alcantara based finish on this. We've got the Audison Voce 5.1K in essence located in here. Then we're gonna have our little badge which sits around about here. And then in here, what we've got is the Lamborghini logo that we're actually 3D printing and designing. Carl's actually working on that as we speak. And he's actually gonna be fabricating a panel that's actually gonna sit in there and then resemble the Lamborghini logo. So that's all basically hidden away in here. However, one of the really cool things is that it's fully retained the actual roof mechanism clamp points on the actual, in this boot area here. So literally the roof can still go in even though we've got an immense amount of amplification. Plus we've also got a processor in here as well. Customer, during the audio consultation, we discussed it when he came by and saw us. I spec this with a little bit of white lighting just to match with the car, plus to match in with some other lighting, which we'll move on to later in the video. So overall, it's gonna be relatively simplistic design, but overall really, really nice looking. So overall, that's basically that area there. In terms of coming into the vehicle, as that gets planted into the vehicle, as you can see, the conduit tubing here, just to make everything neat, tidy, all cable runs that are gonna be running into this tub area. Everything in terms of our wiring is run through alongside manufacturer wiring. So basically cable runs for speaker cables and everything goes through alongside factory grommet positions, but also runs through the actual vehicle through grommets. But actually you can see some of the cable ties that we've added, they've actually means that we've run alongside completely. In essence, the reason why we do that is to actually allow for whenever anyone else is working on the vehicle to easily identify exactly where our stuff is, plus also kind of going through for manufacturer's point of view, looking pretty stock behind the scenes. And these are what these videos are about. It's not about this beauty panel here and how good that looks. It's about the wiring behind the scenes. Our installs go to immense levels, and you'll see why inside the car, full dashboard removal, seats removed, the whole of this interior is basically being removed from front to back to inside the vehicle. There's an immense amount of work that goes into doing these systems. However, it makes a world of difference when they're done. So as you've probably seen in previous behind the sound videos, you've seen this door card being built, how we've actually built these speaker adapters. So if you have missed one of them, make sure you subscribe so you don't miss any future videos, but make sure you go check that out as well. It starts off the whole series of when the car came in to actually where we are right now. So these speaker adapters, I won't touch too much on them, but these have been faced upwards. Then these have got the Audison Thesis speakers in and the doors are pretty much done. However, generally speaking on these event doors, because of how much limited access basically it is in to the actual main area here, we actually leave the door cards off right till the very end, basically until we're all done in here, just to kind of avoid any kind of damage or anything going on to those doors. It's a precautionary measure. Obviously, it's one of those things that it just leaves us a little bit more room to get into and out the vehicle nice and easily. In terms of the actual dashboard, one major thing has changed here since the previous behind the sound video. The actual Audison Thesis custom A-pillars, they are now trimmed, they are now in the vehicle, and the dashboard is ready to go back in. Basically, all our cable runs run behind the dashboard in terms of Target Blue Eye. All the cabling is for that, and we'll talk about Target Blue Eye a bit later on in the video. However, we are integrating that into the factory mirror. In terms of some of the cable runs that we've got in here, we've added a front and rear dash cam, which is an unbelievable achievement, which I'll talk through in a bit. So as you see the actual dash cam here, this is the rear dash camera. It's actually made one small incision hole just in here to get the cable through. And then this is a 3M sticky pad that basically holds that in place. That allows for the glass to come up still, but still retaining the actual functionality of adding in a rear dash cam into the vehicle. We've also added in a battery into the vehicle, which goes in the footwell of this vehicle. In essence, that means this vehicle is now not only protected while on the road, you've got speed camera detection, but you've also got protection while the vehicle is parked. When people are walking around the car, you've got it protected, you've got it on video with full live view. So it's a ThinkWear dash cam that we've added into the system. So we're integrating Apple CarPlay into the factory screen with nothing on display, which is really nice. So there's no separate controller on this, it's fully integrated into the Lamborghini screen. So we're not only adding functionality, upgrading the sound, but also protecting the vehicle overall, plus adding in some really cool devices like Target Blue Eye and full engine bay lighting as well. So all our cable runs again, runs alongside manufacturer wiring behind the dashboard. Everything is actually taped, neatly done. We've actually, on this occasion, customer was quite concerned about any rattles or resonations coming from the vehicle. Obviously, it's one of those things that the more soundproofing we can add in, the more we can limit anything like that from actually occurring. So what we've actually done is fully soundproofed behind the dashboard on the actual vehicle. So the full dashboard has actually been, wherever possible, actually been soundproofed to actually allow and kind of quiet everything down on the vehicle, not only reducing road noise, but reducing those rattles and resonations and stuff like that as well. However, when we build any system, we take that into account, and during the audio consultation we'll talk about how we can counter those sorts of problems and how we've done that on this particular vehicle. We've used a 2mm lining here across the door, mostly because this door needs to go up and down, so we can't add too much weight to it because of the struts. So we use a 2mm soundproofing and pretty much cover most of the card here. Then we've covered the actual back of the card here as well, and then the door card. In terms of inside the actual main cabin here, this actually soundproof with a 3mm layer, so still a product from Skins, and that's basically done from literally about here all the way down to the floor behind the dashboard, and then actually on the back of the dashboard as well. And basically what it does is it reduces those rattles and resonations. This has got the full soundproofing package that we do on these Lamborghinis. It's gone to town on it and it's gonna absolutely rock. It makes the sound system feel so much more solid, plus reducing that road noise as well. So customer pillars are in. The customer actually opted to go for black thesis tweeters, which we've done. So they're in a bit more of a stealth look, which is quite nice actually, rather than having the silver on display, which again, depending on spec, depending on car, it does suit that having a little bit of color added into like a black A-pillar. However, gone for a stealth look, and it looks really nice on the vehicle, plus with the dashboard being black and a lot of the gloss black parts in the vehicle, it looks really, really nice. So moving on, we've now got the engine bay lighting. The customer was after adding in a little bit more kind of color into the system. So what we've added in this engine bay, just to give it a little bit more of a presence, we've actually got a full system here which actually allows for 6 engine bay lights basically. So we've got 2 at the top and then 4 at the bottom, giving a really nice glow over the whole engine. That's actually controlled via a little rocker switch inside the vehicle, plus we've actually got what's called a DRC controller in there as well. Inside here, what we've actually got as well, which is quite nice, is the sub box forming. So we'll talk about the subbox when they're on the bench. However, you see this plate here, this actually is going to bolt onto factory bolt positions, which is quite nice. Again, you can see the soundproofing coming through here. That is basically acoustically soundproof, that whole back panel. So these are the factory panels. We've actually, customers after retaining this little part here. So we've added in the controller into here, the rocker switch. That will still allow this to open and close. However, we're going to have an 8-inch sub between the two seats. So in essence, the idea of adding in the sub is basically to house basically the Audison Prima 8-inch sub. So it's not a massive sub, however, being right between the two seats is exactly how Wilfred's hard spec the vehicle with me as well. It's a really, really nice solution. It's kind of, for a lot of people, more than enough base. However, we do a 10-inch version as well. So if you wanted a 10-inch sub, we can add that between the two seats, and make sure you go check out on Jay Cannon's at Aventador. We actually did a 10-inch Prima sub. However, Wilfred's car plus this one is actually having an 8-inch sub. In terms of the actual sub box, this is the formation of kind of a little bit behind the scenes of how we started building this. So in essence, the 4 holes that you see through here will actually bolt through into the vehicle using factory positions. Then it kind of sits a little bit like this, so it's going to be in essence kind of floating at the bottom edge. That means we have access to actually allow for that panel to open. Obviously that sits quite far back. Then this is the exact volume that the sub requires, and we've still got a couple of bits to do to make this kind of form into the vehicle a lot nicer. However, this is all going to be wrapped in Alcantara. We've got some special elements that are going to be going in. So make sure you subscribe. Check out the final video when this is all done and actually in the vehicle, and you can see the finished product. It honestly will look absolutely lovely when they're all done. But overall, that's basically the sub box to house that 8-inch Prima sub. So we're going to go with a black Alcantara on this finish. And then the sub is going to be on display just like that. and then the rest is going to be Alcantara. However, we've got some design features going round to basically make that blend in a little bit more with the actual vehicle. Obviously, as you can see by the direct contours that we've got going on the actual sub box, it's one of those things. This is a little bit for a beauty panel, but also the design side of it behind the scenes in terms of how we're actually bolting a sub down is very, very important. Any sub that's not bolted down correctly into a vehicle will never perform as it should. Base is all down to what's called excursion of a cone. So on any speaker, for instance, how the sub actually moves up and down and how easily and freely it will move will be not only down to the actual sub that you use, how you're powering it, but also the sub box, how you're building that and what you're putting that into. So it's essential that the sub box is actually designed in a very, very strategic way to allow this to perform how it needs to. But that's where a lot of people go for a larger sub over a smaller sub, because that excursion of that cone, obviously if the cone size is bigger, it can move up and down more, which does in essence give you more output, gives you more bass. However, being right between the two seats, especially with the Thesis woofers playing quite low already, and you've got an immense amount of power from that Audison Voce 5.1K, it makes a world of difference even just having an 8-inch sub there. It performs so nicely, it moves you, and that's what bass is all about, actually moving you, and then you've got that clarity from the top end coming from those Audison Thesis front end. So overall, it's a little bit of a balancing factor. The reason why we use the Audison Prima range on the actual subs, you might be thinking, we've got £1,000 tweeters, we've got £1,000 door speakers, why are we using a Audison Prima sub? So the levels of Audison basically go from Thesis to Voce to Prima. So Prima is their lowest range. Reason is because basically they're one of the best subs that we've found that work into a vehicle like this. Reason is because of the actual space it requires to perform. So like the 8-inch sub only requires literally this much room. It's not a big sub box. The main reason why we use this is because of space. So it's always a little bit of a compromise with sound and a lot of the installs we do, because you've got to compromise not only looks with the vehicle, but also compatibility in terms of how we're actually going to add it into the vehicle. We've got to think about user friendliness. So when you're sitting in the vehicle, you can't have something touching your arm, because you won't be able to use your car and drive properly. So we don't want to obscure your driving, but also we've got to think about looks. We've got to think about sound quality. And that's why we use the Prima sub, because they do perform really, really nicely. But also the volume the actual sub requires is very small, which obviously being between the two seats on the Ventador, there's not a lot of room, so we have to work with that. Hence why the sub box does form into these corners here to give the sub a bit more volume to perform. So overall, that's a bit of a product overview. And then we've also got Target Blue Eye. So this is going to be going into the factory mirror here. So this is the glass for the factory mirror, and we're actually adding in the Target Blue Eye device actually into the factory mirror. So it's all going to be displayed through there. Target Blue Eye is an emergency service warning device that alerts you guys on the road for all approaching emergency service vehicles that is marked and unmarked. Again, this is pretty much the same set that we're doing on Wilfried Zaha's car, so make sure you go check out some of those behind the sound videos as soon as they are released. But overall, it's going to be an immense system. I can't wait to get the car done. I'm sure the customer's going to be over the moon. He's been loving sending him videos of the whole process. I actually sent him one this morning just to give a little bit of an update exactly what we've done over the last couple of days, and we're in constant communication, sending pictures over and bits and pieces just to keep the customer up to date while the system is being done. But I'm sure he's going to be over the moon with the finished product, but so far it's looking absolutely stunning behind the scenes. And that's where a system is really built. It's not about the cosmetic panels, it's built about actually installing everything behind the scenes to the highest possible standards, but also adding in such incredible equipment again to a high standard. Hopefully you've enjoyed this video. There's plenty more to come on this Aventador, but also plenty of other cars as well. So make sure you subscribe, press the like button, but also comment below if you want to see anything else in these behind the sound videos, and we'll do our best to do that for you. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Other than that, thank you very much. We'll see you soon.